Very good evening, everyone. My name is Shubham Singhania, and I'm your mentor for UGC NET Paper 1, Paper 2, Commerce and Management. So, जैसे कहते हैं कि जहां चाह होती है वहां राह निकल ही आती है. So, today I have a very important guest, and that is one of our students, that is Monali Jasani. And she did her post-graduation long back, and then she had worked for 7-8 years in corporate. And उसके बाद उन्हें realize हुआ that she is passionate into teaching, and that is how she started her preparation for UGC NET. In the subject of management, and then she has cracked her neck in management. So, heartiest congratulations, Monali. I welcome you to our channel.
Thank you.
And I'm sure ki jo bhi aaj hum discussion karne wale hain, whatever insights you're going to share with us, your experience, your journey towards the preparation, it is going to be very, very helpful to all our students. So, welcome once again. Okay. So now my first question to you is, please tell us something that what all courses have you pursued? What all experience have you gained before starting your preparation for UGC NET?
So I was in Narasimha Monjee College. I finished my BMS. After that, I pursued MCom, followed by a diploma in family managed business from SPGen. I've worked for 7 to 8 years in Bombay as well as Singapore.
Okay.
In finance, mainly finance was the sector I was working in. And now I have given the NET this year.
Okay, so as you all can see that she has done all her education from top-notch institute. So I have no doubt that unka NET to clear hona hi tha, and she is one of the specialists in finance area also. So I am sure that to all the finance enthusiasts, this interview is going to be very, very interesting, because we are trying to explore much about her finance area and her interest into various domains of finance. Now, my next question is ki Monali, kab aapko realize hua that you want to get into teaching, and when did you actually start your preparation for UGC NET in management?
So I always wanted to teach. I have been volunteering with different NGOs throughout, Teach for India, Kansha Foundation. I used to work at the community center when I was in Singapore as well. So I always wanted to teach. And this year in March, I came across the NET exam. And the application, the registration was open at that point of time. So I went for it without giving it a second thought. I said, I'm just going to register and then figure it out after that.
Right.
So I registered in March and I started preparing in April.
Wonderful. So that basically tells me that aapne approximately 6 months dedicatedly taiyari kari hai.
Right.
So now my next question is, Monali ki, since you have started your preparation after a break, काफी लंबे टाइम का ब्रेक हो गया था. सो व्हाट आर द स्टडी मटेरियल्स दैट हैव यूज्ड स्पेसिफिकली फॉर पेपर 1 एंड पेपर 2? प्लीज टेल अस.
आई हैव सोली ट्रस्टेड द स्टडी मटेरियल दैट यू ऑल हैव प्रोवाइडेड. इन अप्रैल आई लुक्ड एट अ फ्यू ट्यूटोरियल्स दैट वर अवेलेबल. आई डिड अ क्विक गूगल सर्च फॉर मैनेजमेंट, फॉर द मैनेजमेंट सब्जेक्ट, एंड सेड आई जस्ट सॉ व्हिच अदर ऑप्शंस वर आउट देयर. I spoke to different professors from those classes, and then I happened to speak to you. I was comfortable with the brief that you gave me. It seemed very straightforward. You all gave the PDFs, the videos, the live sessions. And I just went ahead with you all. I have only stuck to that material other than statistics and economics, which I referred to a few YouTube videos for difficult concepts. I have solely relied on your PDFs and videos.
Okay, so that tells me that your focus was totally on conceptual clarity, because what I believe is that PDFs, recorded sessions and live sessions helps you enhance that if there is any shortcoming, kahin pe koi cheez samajh mein nahi aa rahi hai, to wo live session mein clear ho jati hai.
Correct. Absolutely. Because, sir, cracking this exam without understanding the concept is a very far shot. It's not like the other exams jahan MCQs टिक कर देते और आपको आंसर मिल जाता है. योर यू नीड टू, बिकॉज देर आर अजर्शन रीजनिंग क्वेश्चंस, देर आर मैच द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चंस, क्रोनोलॉजिकल अरेंजमेंट क्वेश्चंस, यू नीड टू नो द कॉन्सेप्ट वेरी वेरी वेल.
राइट, मेक सेंस. नाउ दैट ब्रिंग्स मी टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन कि सिंस आपने कुछ टाइम के बाद अपनी प्रिपरेशन शुरू करी आफ्टर अ लॉन्ग गैप ऑफ 7-8 इयर्स, सो हाउ डिफिकल्ट वाज इट टू मेंटेन अ डेली रूटीन फॉर योर स्टडीज, और व्हाट स्ट्रेटजी हैव यू फॉलोड?
सो इन द बिगिनिंग आई started taking down notes. I referred to all the PDFs. I took down notes. I made my notes. After that, I was constantly talking to you. Wherever I was stuck or I had a doubt on what to do next, I would just get in touch with you.
Right.
then I refer to the live sessions. The live sessions help me understand the concepts better. So I would go back to the notes, modify whatever concepts I thought that I had not understood in the PDFs. Mm-hmm. Through the live session, through your explanation, I would go and recheck that. Mm-hmm. And the question bank was the next thing that I took on. Started right. subject-wise answering. You all have 100 questions right. at different levels of difficulty. Right. So I started answering those. And the last thing was the past year paper. So these were the steps that I followed to finish the whole portion.
Right. And how many number of hours were you dedicating, Monali?
For the first, so till August, till they did not announce our exam date, I was giving approximately 3 hours every day, mm-hmm. every single day without fail. And after the exam was announced, about 6 to 7 hours every day.
So I think like you have been very consistent in your efforts throughout those 6 months. Is that
100%,
so?
100%. But there were also days, sir, when I was demotivated and it was overwhelming because mm-hmm. I'm studying after so many years.
Right.
There are 20 subjects.
Right.
To give everyone an understanding, it's like you're doing from your FIJC to right. your MCOM, you're cramping 7 years of education right. in one examination. And those 20 subjects were also pretty in-depth.
Right.
So it takes time to get back on it again, but you can only do it if you're doing it every single day. There is no other way that you can get back to this.
Right. And I would certainly support that and recommend that as well. Because see, there are a lot of students who have enrolled with us, jinhone apni preparation 6-7 saal ke gap ke baad shuru kari ho. And definitely yeah. ek thoda sa gap aa jata hai. So you require some consistent effort and time so that you get on to all those concepts. I think that is exactly what you did. You were very consistent in those 6 months of your preparation.
Yes.
Right. Now, that brings me to the next question. Ki, kitna challenging raha? What were the difficulties that you faced? Because the major challenge that I personally felt was ki COVID ke time pe motivation bahut hi low ho raha tha. People were getting demotivated. And this COVID thing was taking a huge toll on all of us. So how did you manage that? And how did you tackle all these challenges?
Absolutely, sir. There was no break. We were just studying. And mm-hmm. after studying, there was nowhere to go or nothing to do because there was a lockdown.
Mm-hmm.
But every time that you feel that you have reached a point of saturation, it's very important to take a step back, to right. give yourself that break. I would just take a few days off mm-hmm. if I felt that it is getting too much. The quality matters more than the quantity.
Right.
So it is not how many hours you put in, but the quality of hours you put in is more important. So I would tell that to anyone. Aapko zarur koi milega who will say that I studied for 7 or 8 hours every day mm-hmm. for maybe 8 months or 1 year. It does not matter if you're doing it for a few hours also, but you're doing it well, you're understanding what you're doing, you will crack the net.
Right. So I think I would certainly agree to that because kya hota hai ki jab aap lagatar padh rahe hain 3 mahine ke liye, 4 mahine ke liye, 6 mahine ke liye, to ek saturation point aa jata hai where you feel that you are no more getting motivation, any kind of motivation to study. To thode se chote chote breaks le len se, I think jo energy down ho gayi hoti hai wo dobara recharge ho jati hai and we are able to start afresh again with a lot of zeal and enthusiasm. So I
100%. Think that, and sir, a lot of people were working simultaneously right. while pursuing the course.
Right.
I was also doing other courses. I was doing a course at Columbia. Then I did right. a course at Harvard, along with preparing for the NET.
Right.
So you are very busy. You need to manage your time well. And
right.
and you know that I also got COVID.
Right.
So I was quarantined for 17 days.
Right.
And that was right before the exam.
Right.
So all of these things are going to happen. You're going to face challenges. It's not going to be a straight road.
Right.
But you have to just keep at it.
Right.
Keep putting in a consistent amount of effort and you will be good.
Right. So I think I really want to emphasize this a lot. Since you're already telling this, Monali, ki kai baar logo ko lagta kya hai jo interview dekh rahe hote hain. कि इट्स द जर्नी हैज बीन वेरी स्मूथ, अरे आराम से तैयारी करके निकल गया होगा, बट यू आर एक्चुअली टेलिंग दैट यू आर परसुइंग साइमल्टेनियसली सम कोर्सेज फ्रॉम हार्वर्ड एज वेल, देन यू आल्सो गॉट कोविड, सो इट टेल्स अस कि कितने एफर्ट्स लगे हैं, कितनी बम्पी राइड्स रही हैं, कितनी स्लीपलेस नाइट रही है इन ऑर्डर टू क्रैक दिस प्रेस्टीजियस एग्जाम ऑफ यूजीसी नेट. सो आई थिंक एक कंसिस्टेंसी मेंटेन करके चलेंगे, इन सारे चैलेंजेस को टैकल करते चलेंगे तो ही एग्जाम निकलेगा. अगर हम गिव अप कर देंगे बीच में, वी विल नॉट बी एबल टू क्वालिफाई.
Absolutely. And we have been talking to our faculty. You have to keep talking to people. You, they will inspire you. They will motivate you. They've been, every time I'm stuck, I've spoken to Shubham sir and he's told me that, okay, you can do this next. Kabhi kabhi sir, bilkul hi padhne ka man nahi karta, toh I used to just watch videos. Right. I used to take a few days and just watch videos so that at least I'm listening and I'm learning and I'm not wasting time. But that discipline needs to be there.
Right. I think speaking to your professor, speaking to your close friend with whom you can discuss your challenges helps a lot. Because wo phase se go through kar chuke hain, all those who have given those exams, they know that it's a struggling journey and it's
yes.
And I always say it's not a sprint, it's a marathon. Jahan aapko 6 mahine, 8 mahine, 3 mahine and probably is attempt mein to 11 mahine ka bhi time phase ho gaya tha jinhone January mein preparation shuru kar di thi.
Yeah, and sir, this has been like a mentally draining time for everybody.
Right.
Because we have all been in such a different situation. None of us have been in this situation ever before. Ja,
right.
Ghar se nahi nikalna hai, or you don't know how the next day is going to look. Your family and friends have been affected by COVID.
Right.
So many things in the world are happening, which is not the most pleasant news. So in this, these times, I feel all the people who have cleared NET at this point of time, I have immense respect for you all.
Absolutely. My next question is, a lot of students say, ki, sir, hum kya sirf past years laga ke chale jayen, sirf mock test laga ke chale jayen. So how useful were the past year papers? Kitne saal ke aapne past years paper lagaye and kitne mock test aapne practice kiye?
Sir, I may be incorrect, but I don't think ke past years lagane se ye exam crack ho sakti hai because every past year was different. I mainly refer to the past years to map my timing, to know how much time I am spending on each subject or what type of questions. So to manage timings, to get an idea of the flow of the paper, to understand ke kaise type ke questions aate, every paper was different.
Right.
So, aisa nahi hai ki, and to top it, the paper that we gave this year was absolutely different from the pattern of the previous mock tests.
Right.
So, you should practice it. You should do it. But about 7 to 8 is enough. And as per your recommendation, I only looked at the past years from 2018. Nothing
right.
before that.
Right.
Because the type of questions asked before that were very different than after. In the recent years, they are asking more analytical questions.
Right.
Questions that are not simple MCQs where 4 options are given and you pick the right option. They are
right.
lengthier questions. They are time consuming. They're asking you at least 4 to 5 concepts in one question.
Right.
So do the past years, but don't spend too much time. Try to understand the concept better is something that I would recommend.
So I would say that you're absolutely correct. And the reason for the same is ki 2018 के बाद से पैटर्न चेंज हो गया है फॉर द काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन दे आर आस्किंग बिकॉज अर्लियर इट वॉज कंडक्टेड बाई UGC एंड देन इट वॉज कंडक्टेड बाई CBSE. नाउ द एग्जाम इज कंडक्टेड बाई NTA विच स्पेशलाइजेज इन टू मेकिंग ओनली द क्वेश्चन. So that is the reason probably that why they are focusing more on conceptual clarity and analytical based question. So main kafi baar student se baat karta hu and wo kehte hain ki sir easy questions kyun nahi kara rahe, why are you giving us difficult question. Live session mein bhi ek important bouncers question ke naam se, agar Monali aapko yaad ho, live session bouncers question famous ho gaye the because they used to be very tricky.
Sir, also the last 2 weeks where you did live sessions just before the exam,
right.
That was very helpful because it was time-based tha and they were live. Everyone was answering the questions live. It was very motivating.
Right.
And the Telegram group in the last month was very active. Sab log us pe doubts pooch rahe the and every single person has been helpful enough. Jisko jo aata tha, wo share kar dete the ke mujhe iska ye answer pata hai.
Right.
And it was it everyone together, that was very motivating to have people around you who are in the same situation as you.
Right. And probably that is the reason why we emphasize ki Telegram group banane se and kuch frequent calls agar faculty ke saath arrange, jo hum hamesha koshish karte hain ki hum apne students se touch mein rahein. Because kai baar aisa hota hai ki हम इंडिविजुअल ध्यान नहीं दे पाते एंड यू गाइस आर आल्सो ग्रोन अप बट इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट कि जब आपको जरूरत हो एटलीस्ट यू कैन स्पीक टू द फैकल्टी ऑन कॉल्स और ऑन टेलीग्राम ग्रुप और ऑन पर्सनल चैट सो दैट आपके स्पेसिफिक प्रॉब्लम जो कि होंगे हर स्टूडेंट के एक स्पेसिफिक प्रॉब्लम्स होंगे उनको हम डिस्कस करके एड्रेस कर सके. सो आई थिंक दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू हैव अ कम्युनिकेशन विद योर फैकल्टी. अगर कम्युनिकेशन नहीं है दोज आई थिंक दोज चैलेंजेस वोंट बी एबल टू रिजॉल्व.
यस एंड सर यू ऑल हैव ऑलवेज बीन अवेलेबल. It is on, it can be on WhatsApp, on Telegram, on call. I have, whatever doubts I have had, you have help me clear them. I don't think aapke mentorship ke bina I would have cleared the net this time. That also in the first attempt, it was not possible.
So thank you so much for saying that. So we are just trying our best because I also tell you that a lot of students feel ki hamara ab exam ho gaya hai. We have cracked our net and they still speak to me regarding their PhD, their proposal and regarding their topic. So I believe it's very important to be in touch because see, though we are meeting online, but somehow we at Anuj Jindal focuses on building bonds with our students. And I'm very glad to say that we have actually built that bond over that period of 4 years. So, and that is 100%. Certainly help all our students.
Yes.
Bahut sari baatein ho gayi strategy ke baare mein. Now let's talk about your future plans. So now since you have cracked net, what is your plan ahead with the future? Do you plan to get into teaching? Do you want to pursue your research or PhD? What are you planning, Monali?
Sir, the subject area that I'm interested in is sustainability. Mm-hmm. I'm doing a lot of reading in that area. Mm-hmm. And I'm trying to zero down on a topic that is interesting enough and I feel that needs to be addressed or researched on enough. Mm-hmm. Once I find that topic, I want to dedicate the next 4 to 5 years on a PhD. And only after that, I want to take up teaching because it is my understanding that after doing a PhD and researching so much in that subject, we then understand a subject good enough to teach it to other people. Right. So I want to do full justice when I take up the profession of teaching. So I will first focus on finding my research topic and after that, take up teaching.
I'm very glad because a lot of students I speak to, unko clarity nahi hoti hai. They just want to push into PhD ki abhi MCOM khatam kiya, masters khatam kiya, and jaldi se PhD enroll karane. But I think that's a very strategic move or a systematic move ki pehle knowledge acquire kar lo theek se so that you will be able to justify your teaching. So
yes, and we are spending 5 years with that topic. That right. topic means we need to be passionate enough about that topic to do it day and night every day for 5 years. Kabhi kabhi abhi lagta hai ki haan bahut interesting hai, but after 6 to 8 months you lose the motivation.
Right.
So it is better to take a few months now than spend 5 years doing something that you are not really enjoying.
I think though it is off the topic, but this is something you have said and it really means a lot because काफी सारे पीएचडी स्टूडेंट्स होते हैं. सो इफ यू गो एंड इफ यू रीड अबाउट थिंग्स, देयर आर लॉट ऑफ पीएचडी स्टूडेंट्स, पीएचडी स्कॉलर्स हु आर एक्चुअली इनटू डिप्रेशन. एंड उसका रीजन यही है कि उन्होंने जो टॉपिक, यस, एंड दैट इज बिकॉज द टॉपिक दैट दे हैव चोजन इज नॉट आउट ऑफ देयर इंटरेस्ट. इट इज समथिंग दैट इज बीन अलॉटेड टू देम बाय द यूनिवर्सिटी और प्रोबब्ली बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रेशर फ्रॉम द गाइड्स. सो that I think that leads to a lot of demotivation for the students. So rather than getting into any topic randomly, I think interest develop karna bahut zaruri hai and then only you should be going for your topic. So this is for all the students who are planning to go for PhD. Please choose your topic based on your interest. Don't choose a topic randomly because it has been told to you by some professors or by your seniors. Don't do that.
Yes.
Right. Now that's the last question from my side, that what is one advice that you would like to give to all our future aspirants of UGC NET who are going to write the exam in June 2021?
Consistency, every single day, consistency and discipline. If you only do it for 5 to 6 months, you will not have to give multiple attempts. Bahut baar ho jata hai ki do baar, teen baar NET de dete hai, but they don't clear it. But if you do it one time with complete dedication, you will be able to clear it. The second thing is don't refer to too many study materials. Take up one and understand that thoroughly, completely. Understand the concept. Ab jo bhi access kar rahe, because and ye maine aapse sikha ke whatever you're doing, do that properly. Aapne bahut end, aap hamesha end mein bolte the ke don't do anything new right now. Right. What you know, understand the concept 100%. And the last thing is believe in yourself. Koi kuch bhi bol le ke you can do it or you cannot do it. You trust yourself, you will do it.
Right. So I think Monali has followed all of these three steps or three pointers that I must say. And that has brought her here today, that she is telling you her experience and how she has qualified this prestigious exam of UGC NET in management in her first attempt. So heartiest congratulations, Monali, once again. And thank you so much for finding time out of your busy schedule and coming on our channel and sharing your experience. And thank you once again. And
thank you. I'm truly humbled.
Thank you. Thank you.